The latest version of the Debian GNU/Linux operating system, named Bullseye, has now been released. Debian Bullseye is the 11th major release of Debian, which is one of the oldest and most popular Linux distributions today. Bullseye contains the usual batch of new software, which are as usual already outdated. It contains GNOME 3.38, KDE Plasma 5.21, LibreOffice 7, Firefox 78 ESR, XFCE 4.16, Cinnamon 4.8, among much else, and will be supported till around 2024. Debian is by far my favorite Linux distro. I love everything about it. Its ease of use, its community, its stability as a distribution, and the sheer vastness of the project as a whole. It covers almost every modern processor and quite a few older ones as well, and has around 60,000 packages for my processor, AMD 64. So anyways, today I just wanted to discuss how to download and install Debian Bullseye on your computer, which is actually a bit different compared to most other Linux distros. Also, I'm making another video on what extra steps I do to set up my Debian install, to make it feel like a more complete experience, covering stuff like package managers and docs and other quality of life changes, which I would definitely recommend. So subscribe if you want to watch that video as soon as it comes out, though probably it's already released by the time you're watching this. Anyways, let's get right into it. Go to www.debian.org, which is the Debian's website. Obviously it will load. Then once you click on download, it will take you to this page. As you can see, Bullseye has actually not been released, it's still showing Debian 10.10. It's about to be released in what, a few hours from now, so almost here. I'm using testing right now. Anyway, Bullseye is here, you will automatically be given a file to download. I should have mentioned that. I cancelled that download purposefully. Instead, what you want is the live ISO. The regular Debian installer is, let's just say, too complex for most users. I have screwed it, 10-20 times trying to install Debian using that installer. So I always recommend the live ISO installer, which contains Calamities, which is used in many more Linux distros. Also, as you can see, unofficial installers with non-free firmware, helpful for video and network adapters, can be downloaded from this place. Most Wi-Fi chips and Bluetooth chips won't work without this unofficial installer, so I would always recommend going for the unofficial installer because it works on many more devices. Once you are here, you need to click on this. This will obviously say 11.0 by the time you are watching this video, non-free. You want to go to the live non-free, live plus non-free folder, AMD 64 or whatever your architecture is. Mine is AMD 64. ISO hybrid, and then whatever desktop environment you want. I personally like XFCE, so you can choose whatever you want. Then you can simply click on the ISO file and install it. I already have installed, so I will not download it again. Once you have the ISO file, the installation is very straightforward. It's just like any other distro. You need to flash the ISO file to a USB drive, boot from it, and then you can click the live installer in the desktop. There are several tutorials available for this. Some of the new features in Debian Bullseye include better support for driverless printing and scanning. Scanning is now available, it was not available earlier. A new open command has been used so that you can just open a file using the terminal, and it will be opened by whatever the default application for opening that file is. And Win32 loader, which is a software which is used for installing Debian through Windows. Now it supports UEFI and secure boot. So it's actually quite usable now, because Windows 10 I think does not work if the other operating systems do not use secure boot. And there are several more changes. Most of them don't apply to most normal users. And the new theme is the stunning theme Home World. And this is the desktop background default. Anyways, that's it for this video. A huge thanks to the Debian project for releasing such a Great project, and congratulations for the new release. And that's it for this video. If you like this video, please like and subscribe and share and